Lindsay. I'm originally from New Zealand. I'm a painter. I paint 8 different styles, from cityscapes, fantasy art, nudes, abstracts, a little bit of Kiwiana. I've been here for the last 8 years in London, and I like to paint a whole lot of different styles just to cater to different sides of my character. The cityscapes are generally my most popular ones, and they're places that I've personally been or have visited. When the BT Art Box project presented itself, I've sort of read the brief and had a bit of a brainstorm and decided that I wanted to combine two quintessentially British icons. So I thought, by looking at the shape of the phone box, then what icons were there that were a similar shape to a phone box? And Big Ben was an obvious choice. So Big Ben also has a lot of personal meaning to me. It's somewhere that I always take friends and family when they first come to London. And also, with this year being the Queen's Jubilee and the Olympics, and with so much tourism coming into a beautiful city, then I just thought, what better way than to combine two quintessentially British icons during this period of time. The characters all in the windows of my Big Ben, they're all symbolic, and they're a collection of suggestions from different people that have crossed my path, from the Children and Child line to people that have worked within the BT Art Box project, to different artists, people I work with, people I live with. So there's a little bit of everybody within this Big Ben. It's not just completely, I just wanted to share a little bit of me with everybody else. And so when they would come here, then it would mean something to them as well. As far as the Big Ben story goes, you can see it here. So we, from the idea right through to auction. So the idea was just to turn it into Big Ben. There were 80 of us in a warehouse in Lewisham, so we all were given a blank phone box to turn it into whatever our design was. I had a 5-foot roof made, and then slowly I just went in every day with my tiny little paintbrush until it slowly became the Big Ben that it is now. There are numerous personalities in the windows. There is, we've got New Zealanders, New Zealand Olympians, British Olympians. We've got an English favourite bagpuss, Lewis Hamilton. We've got a collection of Olympians from around the world, South Africa, Italy, Ireland. The Children of Childline suggested Esther Ranston, because without her there would be no Childline. David Beckham, Lady Gaga, Jessie J. Because the children all felt that they were inspirational people to them. We had a private view at the BT Art Box warehouse, where there was about sort of, I don't know, 40 odd within the warehouse. A lucky 20 came to Trafalgar Square for the press launch. So myself, Big Ben was one of them, and also you've got Muncha, the yellow knitted art box, was also at the press launch. So these two have been together for the last month or so from Trafalgar Square on the roundabout. So we've also, they've been sponsored by different companies. And Big Ben was lucky enough to be sponsored by Channel 4. So thank you, Channel 4. As far as they've been all over the British press and the Independent and the Metro, BBC. BBC has came to interview a few of us at the warehouse. Also, myself and Benjamin Shine, who created 3 phone boxes, took Long Distance, which is a real phone box with a giraffe up top, and also 2 BT Art Box lounges, a red one and a purple one. So this is on Sunday brunch with Tim Lovejoy, just talking about the BT Art Box project. And in next week, well, they're on the roundabout for another week or so, and in a week's time they'll all be auctioned off for Childline. As far as Childline goes, I've tried to keep it symbolic with the times of the clocks. So I've set the clocks to 8 o'clock and 11 minutes past 11, which is the childline phone number 0800 1111. If you want to buy a BT Outbox, then all the information is on the BT Outbox website. We've got a week left, and the website is btoutboxes.com. Thank you.